Hi, Graham again from Nevada Cloud, and today I'm going to do an introduction to the Hess test found within the Spectrum iCare software system. It's crucial to understand the background of the Hess test. We'll cover this first before showing you how to set it up and the plotting process. This is a great test that can be used to detect and diagnose abnormalities that could answer many of the questions we have about some of those complicated cases we get occasionally. What the HEST essentially does is it gives you a direct foveal projection of where the patient's eyes are fixating through the 9 primary positions of gaze. It essentially gives you a graphical plot of what you'd get if you were to do the cover test in all 9 positions of gaze. You can get a good understanding of both concomitant and incomitant deviation. One just needs to be cognizant of the fact that because it's done under dissociated conditions, it'll give you phorias as well as tropias. The HESS actually detects and gives you a plot of the underacting and overacting extraocular muscle function. By giving you a graphical plot, you're able to compare very accurate plots over a period of time. This is so you can document any changes that might occur. So let's first have a look how it's done. For this demonstration, we're going to use the HESS test that's included in the Spectrum program as mentioned earlier. You can also download the HESS test only, which is available free of charge directly from their website. Firstly, let's look at how to access the HESS test from within the Spectrum program. You go up here first and you select auxiliary on the top menu bar, and then you select the HESS on the lower menu bar over here. This will open the HESS intro screen. By the way, this is the screen you'll see if you download the test directly. If you select help from this screen, it'll give you the practitioner guidelines of how to conduct the test. Okay, so by default, the patient is positioned 50 centimeters from the computer screen. It's essential that they are positioned centrally and perpendicular to the screen. As I mentioned earlier, the program defaults to 50 centimeters, but if you want to plot a wider field, you can position the patient closer, but then be sure to edit and save the distance from the screen on the options menu over here. Also be sure that the patient's head position is correct. Must not be tilted or turned to the left or turned to the right. Be very careful of multifocal wearers who habitually will lift their chins while working with the computer. That's just generally what they do. So just be sure they're not doing that. We ask the patient to place their elbow on the desk or on the table and put their chin in the palm of their hand, like so. This will adequately immobilize their head movements throughout the entire test. During its exam, it's essential that they hold the position exactly in this position to eliminate any movements whatsoever. Once a patient's set up in the correct position, one needs to switch off all the lights in the room. This has to be done in total darkness. The patient must only be able to see the screen. Before plotting, the patient must wear the red-green anaglyphs with the red lens in front of the right eye and the green lens in front of the left eye. Simple way to remember this is RR, red for right. So let's see what the patient will see while they are plotting. The patient sees the red dot with the red eye, which is also known as the fixating eye. After going through all 9 positions of gaze, the program will switch the colors of the ring and the dot, and then the left eye with the green filter becomes the fixating eye, and the eye with the red filter is the plotting eye. We're measuring the deviation of the eye that is plotting. So there you have it. In our next video, we'll go through the interpretation of the results, and in the final video in this series, we will offer diagnoses and in some cases, some prescribing suggestions. Thank you.